the Los Angeles Lakers so much to change this season compared to what we've seen from them in the past. LeBron James joins, of course. I think he is a little bit at risk of getting overdrafted, going off the board at pick 5 in many leagues. I don't think he's going to play all 82 games. I don't think he's going to play the same minutes load that he played in Cleveland. And all this talk of him taking a step back from ball handling duties worries me a little bit, having him as a fifth overall pick. There's also the concerns with Lonzo Ball, who legitimately has top 30, top 25 type upside, but with the knee injury to slow things down for him at the beginning of the season, Rajon Rondo and LeBron's insistence on perhaps bringing him in and maybe giving him some minutes do worry me a little bit with Ball, and as well as LeBron taking some of those stellar assist numbers that Lonzo got last season. I imagine he does improve his percentages, but I still think that he is probably not going to realize his potential this season. A few guys on the Lakers I do believe are being overdrafted as well. Brandon Ingram and Kyle Kuzma. I find it hard for Kuzma to be able to replicate exactly what he did last season in terms of usage and efficiency, and he doesn't contribute in many other areas. So if he's being picked in the top 100, which it is, you know, pick 75 on Yahoo, that feels way too high for me. And Brandon Ingram really excelled at the end of last season with his three-point shooting, but it was a limited sample size, so who knows if that's real. He also played really well when Ball was out, and he had the ball in his hands the majority of that time. Now he's got to share it with Lonzo, with LeBron, with perhaps Rondo, with perhaps Lance Stephenson. So I think some of Ingram's value may be a little bit overstated. The center position, there's some value potentially there. You look at JaVale McGee as a late round pick. Maybe it's if it's a Zubats, whoever gets 20 plus minutes there could chime in with some decent rebound and block numbers, whereas guys like Kentavious Caldwell-Pope and Josh Hart are more of your waiver wire type guys. So I think there's a real risk that majority of Lakers guys get a little bit overdrafted for this upcoming season.